So here's one possible design for coding up a solver for these types of problems. And that design would be to write down all the rules of arithmetic in terms of carry digits, in terms of odd and even, and so on. Now, that seems like a challenging task. There's a lot of complexity involved in understanding all the rules about arithmetic. And even if we figured out everything about addition, there's also subtraction and multiplication and other operators. And so what we really want is a shortcut that will allow us to eliminate this complexity. So let's go back to the back of the envelope and try to see if we can figure out a shortcut. And one possibility would be to try all possibilities. There are 10 digits. And so all combinations of digits, all permutations of the digits, rather, would be only 10 factorial, which I happen to know is about 3 million. And that's not so many. So it seems like it's feasible for us to try all the possibilities. It's not going to be super quick. We would rather have this be thousands rather than millions, because there seems to be a fair amount of work in substituting in all the letters with digits. But we can expect to be able to try all millions in not within a second, but within about a minute or so. So now we have an improved design, which is we represent our formula as a string, and we'll use official Python notation here with the double equal sign. And then we fill in with all permutations of the 10 digits for each of the letters. And if there's fewer letters, we have to account for that. And so, for example, we might substitute a 1 for the O's and a 2 for the D's and a 3 for the E's and a 4 for the V's and a 5 for the N's, and otherwise just copy the equation and then evaluate that and check if that's equal to true. And if it is, then we have a solution. If it's not, we'll go back and we'll try another combination, maybe 1, 3, 3, and so on. We'll keep on going through until we find some permutation that works. So that's the design. Now let's take an inventory of all the concepts we're going to need. First, we have equations, and there's two types of those, the original and the filled in. The original has letters, the filled in has digits. Letters and digits are concepts we have to deal with. And the assignment of a letter to a digit, or a set of those, is also a concept we have to deal with. And I think that's pretty much it. Maybe one more concept is evaluation or validation that the filled-in equation is an accurate one. So now let's come up with some choices to represent each of these concepts. So the original equation can be a string. The filled-in equation can also be a string. The letters will be single character strings like D. The digits will also be single character strings like 3. The assignment of letters to digits will be some sort of a mapping or a table that has consists of this type of mapping that says D would be replaced by 3, and so on. And it turns out that there is a facility built into Python that's part of strings called the translate function. So we can call the string.translate method in order to enact that type of assignment or substitution. And then for the evaluation, there's a function called eval in Python, which takes a string and evaluates it as an expression. You may not be that familiar with these last two items, so let's go over them. Eval is pretty simple. If we asked for eval of the string 2 plus 2, then that would give us a value 4. And if we asked for eval of the string 2 plus 2 equals 3, Python would evaluate that using its normal rules and tell us that that's equal to false.